And one thing's for sure, it can do a whole lot of things, but it also has a huge legacy.
About 70 people make up the crew of the latest ship to bear the name of Indianapolis.
20 of those will be in the mine warfare detachment. And then we will also embark a 23 personnel for aviation operations.
The littoral combat ship is filled with Indy references and is designed to take on coastal threats like submarines, swarming small crafts, and mines.
This ship in particular will have the mine warfare mission package installed, which has various surface vehicles, boats, as well as airborne systems for mine hunting and mine neutralization.
All the features you need to defend the United States of America. But something else needed, a little heart and sacrifice.
We protect our nation, and you know, we have to be prepared to do that. We're prepared to give our lives in the service of our country.
A service more than 1,000 sailors gave on July 30th, 1945, when the second generation of the USS Indianapolis was torpedoed by a Japanese submarine.
5 days they spent in the water waiting for rescue. The encounters with sharks, seeing, you know, someone right in front of their eyes be attacked by a shark.
92-year-old Dick Thielen was one of the survivors.
Oh yeah, I see men taken from sharks 15, 20 feet away.
He says thinking about his dad helped him survive 4 days and 5 nights stranded in the water.
Every time I was ready to give up, I feel dad's grip. I could see dad's face. And I got home and I told my dad that. And dad, a little rough talking, how the hell did I do that? You did it. If I didn't have him to think about, I would never have got it. I'd give up.
Thielen didn't think he would live to see this brand new ship, but he's grateful and willing to pass along his knowledge to people like Joshua Gaskell from Liston, Indiana.
Getting a chance to meet the survivors was pretty damn awesome.
So as Thielen heads off the ship to go back to his home in Michigan.
Seaman second class, Dick Thielen.
He can only offer Gaskell and all the other crew members one piece of advice.
Don't ever give up.
The future USS Indianapolis will be commissioned this Saturday at the Port of Indiana, Burns Harbor. Aaron Cantrell, back to you.
All right, Aaron, thank you. As we said, this is the fourth.